in ordinary, I burned all the slides except the one that led to Hedron. Trench used one of the burned ones to open a door to the Hiss. Did Darling hide the Hedron slide? Did Trench destroy it? Hedron guided me here, only now, after it spent years locked in a cage. Why not before? Because they want me to free it. If it were not here to free it, it brought me to fight the Hiss.
Ha! Especially considering the pound of shells.
At least the hiss bleed. Usually the shit here is like, I don't know, an angry rocking chair.
Requires a slide to open dimensional door. Hi, Jesse.
How do you feel about me taking over as director?
You act like it just happened. You've been director since we first met, remember? I am still thrilled. Nothing's changed. Not for me. But the Bureau has changed. Trench and Darling are gone. Their knowledge, anything not written down, disappeared with them. They knew the Bureau better than anyone.
They're the Bureau's past, Emily. We won't operate like they did. We'll learn from their mistakes. We'll be better than they ever were.
We won't ever be like them.
When the hiss got into my head, I saw some weird things. I think Darling even spoke to me. Does that make any sense to you?
Empirically, no, but phantom voices as well as hallucinatory states are not uncommon here. And considering the forces that Dr. Darling was working with, he could have been transferred to a different plane of consciousness, physically or otherwise.
And that doesn't upset you?
Oh, very. And the fact that he hid those forces from me? It's infuriating. But Darling's dream was always to look beyond our reality. This time he may have taken a step too far, but as long as his consciousness can perceive his surroundings, I'm sure he's loving it.
Maybe Darling was just trying to protect you from the darker side of his work.
Fuck that. I'm not a child. Like, don't just assume I'm going to consider something morally repugnant.
Which it all was.
Which it all was, of course.
How is Dylan?
The same. I can't detect any hiss activity, but his physiology has certainly been altered by it. And I can't tell if his brain activity is genuine or simply the aftermath of the hiss, like spasms. Dylan could wake up tomorrow for all I know. I really can't say.
Then I just have to wait for him. That's fair. He waited a long time for me.
Don't worry. We'll be monitoring him round the clock. If he wakes up, we'll be ready. I don't mean that in a hostile way, just... well, you know.
I hear you. My brother isn't exactly popular around here.
I hope one day he'll have the chance to change that.
So, there was a moment after Hedron died, that I couldn't feel my powers. The hiss got into my head. Just for a moment.
So that explains the HRA outage. Before we knew what was happening, the hiss had us. They were in my head. I saw terrible things. I mean, I was about to go under forever when the hiss was pushed back. The HRAs had come back on. Dylan vanished afterwards, and we fought off the hiss that came after him. So if Hedron's death knocked out the HRAs, that means there must be a new local source for them to relay, which I'm guessing must be...
Me.
You. Hedron is dead, assuming that word even applies to a resonant-based life form. But whatever it awakened in you, the power you call Polaris, is still active. Or at least, that's what my instruments are telling me.
I don't think we're ever gonna understand all of this. And I'm okay with that. I'm just glad you're here with me.
That's good to know. Thanks, Emily. I found Dylan attacking the astral plane and the board. What was he hoping to accomplish?
Huh. Since they arrived, Hiss have been corrupting objects of power, which have an inherent link to the astral plane. Maybe their goal was to access the astral plane and the board itself.
That still doesn't tell us why.
His motives are a difficult thing to work out, but I have been digging through confidential files and noticed a strange gap in knowledge regarding the board. Looks like any data on them has either been deleted or was never gathered in the first place.
Then maybe it's time someone looked into that.
Maybe it is.
Well, I've got a bureau to run. See you soon.
Yes, ma'am, Director Faden.
Please, Emily. Not even as a joke.
Any sightings in the Ocean View Motel? Could survivors be hiding inside? It's possible. I remember.
My life's been a strange.
This is Director Faden. Send a ranger to my position.
The Hiss are in for it now!
41 days since entry day, the name of our historic arrival to the oldest house. Morale is long dead, and its corpse is starting to smell. My research staff complain of a presence watching them. Many have suffered nervous fits. Some were evacuated. In cheerier news, I've made some new friends. I met them while exploring the deeper caves. They're hard to describe, but imagine avant-garde sculptures of humans. I call them the Id. They aren't hostile. In fact, they're polite and quiet, which is more than I can say for my colleagues. Most Id are shy, but a few are quite curious. While I sat taking notes, one came to look at my sketches. I offered him my pencil, but that spooked it. What are the Id? Residents? Prisoners? They remind me of the golems from Kabbalistic texts, or a type of homunculi. I know I shouldn't, but I gave them names. There's Hercules, Adam, Lilith, Copernicus. Mabel is the bravest. They're a funny bunch.
Thank you.
see a thing. Maybe I should have thought this through. TV. So dark. How am I supposed to drag this thing out of here? This is fine, Jesse. You're okay. Just don't drop the TV. Thank you. There's the way out. Up there. Back at the cell. Thank God.